All right, so today we're here to talk to you about our ensuite renovation. We've had this planned for years, and we're so thrilled how it turned out. We can't wait to dive into it with you. So her vision for the space was to really create a serenity-like, spa-like atmosphere. I think we were inspired by some of the really nice bathrooms that we stayed at hotels in the recent years.
Yeah, I feel like we lead busy, hectic lives, obviously, with the company and kids. So we really wanted the ensuite to be a place where we could escape and that sense of serenity and this sort of like moodiness and calmness that you can have at the end of the night and calmness for, you know, first thing in the morning, just being able to walk into a serene space and start your day off right. That was really a key factor, I think, in the design vision.
Absolutely.
So we like to call our style warm modern, and that is how we execute our designs and create the vision. For us, warm modern is high contrast, you know, minimalistic elements, clean lines, and then that introduction of warmth with wood and brass and layers. Layering is key with lighting and decor. I think we, you know, have always been a little bit obsessed with decor right from the beginning of our career.
Paint, decor, and more. That used to be the original name of the company.
It's sad but true. For us, it's such a unique way to introduce, you know, personality and specific elements into a space. You can bring in texture and color and pattern, you know, with rugs and art is such a big thing for us as well.
Even in this ensuite, just choosing the right piece of art for this little space was the final detail that really brought it all together, in my opinion.
The minute that you walk into the ensuite, you're confronted with the masterpiece of a vanity. That was a huge element of design for us, and something we really love to do when we're designing bathrooms is the vanity. Thinking about, obviously, not only its functionality, but how we can kind of elevate it to another level with the details. And I think this one was a big one for us, obviously because it was ours, but also because it is the first thing that you see when you walk in that space. And you can even see it from the bedroom. So we wanted it to be an extension of the bedroom, but also just this really big focal point in the space, I think, in a grounding detail.
In a lot of homes, sometimes there's just one bathroom upstairs in older homes, so you don't want to lose the tub in that situation. But for us, we were able to do away with it, and we're so thrilled that we did, because we can't say how much we love our shower.
Oh my gosh, it definitely is one of those things where, you know, you think about it, you design it, you envision it, and then when we finally saw that end result, it was even better than we could have imagined. And being in that space and using that space, it's been, you know, a complete blessing, obviously, again, just because it's so beautiful, but also just the functionality of the space. I mean, we have proper storage, and just being able to have that counter space and the sink space and like a larger shower, it's been just amazing to be able to use that space. So I think we were pretty set on a black countertop right from the get-go. I think we wavered a little bit back and forth, but that was sort of an original design detail that we had come up with. We wanted something that was impactful, high contrast, and we loved the idea of this, you know, waterfall edge, something that was thicker than a typical vanity countertop. Mm-hmm. That we selected right from the get-go. We saw a few different countertop selections, you know, something that had less veining, something that had more veining. It was definitely risky going with something that had that heavy veining, just because with a waterfall edge, it's quite complicated to...
It was a little tricky to get right.
Yeah, you have to be able to kind of match those lines up. So the installation was very specific, which I'm not sure if they were too happy with us at the time, but it turned out to be so beautiful and we're so happy with that design decision.
Yeah, amazing.
I think when we were selecting the base, again, I think we had chosen oak or a wood base pretty early on. We wanted it to have that organic feel. I think introducing wood in a bathroom is always nice. You have so much tile and typically sort of a base color, whether it's gray or white. And that introduction of like organic wood just warms up the space. It makes it feel more homey. That was a big feature for us, I think.
Yeah, for sure. And then we did the wood shelves in the corner too. I think at first in the design, we weren't gonna utilize that corner, just the way the shower is positioned.
Yeah.
But then I started to think, well, if it's a dead corner, why don't we utilize it? So we ended up running the counter all the way into the corner.
Yeah.
And doing two beautiful wood shelves with integrated LED lights in there too. So it gives a little moment to create a little vignette and add some little decor and just add a little bit more personality and texture to the space. And it's just a beautiful,
beautiful and
nice touch.
Completely functional.
So we decided to do lighting under the vanity, just again for that ambiance. It's just a nice little touch, especially late at night where we're taking spa-like shower moment. Just adds that glow to the space, which I really love.
Yeah. I thought you were a little crazy maybe originally when you were starting to go a little haywire with all the lighting that you were suggesting that we put in the bathroom. I was like, this is going to be a lot of lighting.
No, because I really think, especially in en-suites, layered lighting is so key. I think when, you know, we go to a hotel and there's like one light in the bathroom and then there's no dimmers.
It doesn't
give you that feeling. So having multiple light sources and dimmers on all of them really lets you set the tone and the mood of the ensuite. So
no,
that's
it
so
is
key.
Perfect. So each lighting element is on its own switch. We have pot lights, we have sconces beside each of the mirrors, and we have those LED strips all throughout the space, and they each add their own element and are equally functional as well as beautiful.
That's right. Why don't we talk about the big feature that I think we've gotten the most questions from is the towel ladder.
Yeah.
So the towel ladder came to be because we were searching for a solution, obviously, where to put towels, and there was basically features on every wall. There was a door, window, a vanity, and then a glass shower. So that didn't leave much space for hanging towels, and we wanted a large space for it. So we came up with this idea to do a towel ladder that would be in front of the glass. So we utilized this empty space between the toilet and the glass. And then our contractor came up with a solution to install it completely flush. So they went into the attic to create a brace for it. And then since we were replacing the tile and doing everything like that, they installed braces underneath the tile and then that poked through the tile. So they were able to install it completely flush, which looks absolutely stunning. So many people scratch their head and say, how
did you do that? Because you could just bolt it down, but we really wanted to make it as seamless as possible, and they did an awesome job. So when we were selecting the tile, we knew we wanted it to be neutral, have some type of textural element. We didn't want it to be plain necessarily. So the floor tile was an oversized tile with a rough matte texture, and the wall tile was this uneven surface with this shiny, glossy exterior that we knew would be highlighted by that LED lighting, which is really important.
What I love about that tile is that it's imperfect and they all look completely unique, but I love the finish effect, that it's that really handmade feeling and texture on the walls. It's just absolutely amazing.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so another feature that we incorporated in the ensuite are the vents. And actually we get a ton of questions about them, which is fun. So these are called area vents. It's actually a Canadian company that we collaborated with on this project. But we've been using them throughout our projects anyways, because we absolutely love how they look. They're extremely minimal. And how you install them is you put them in the floor before you do the tile, and then you inset and cut a tile inside the tray, and it creates this really
seamless
look. It just looks absolutely beautiful and you barely see the tile, and you can even continue the pattern inside the tray, which is a really nice little feature. And they recently also came out with a wall vent, so you can do the drywall inside the tray, and it just looks absolutely seamless. It's just such a modern look, and we really love how that turned out.
Mm-hmm. So we love to mix metals in a space, although some people might think of that as a faux pas. We absolutely love it. We feel like it brings this unique, you know, design vision to life. So we obviously went with the black metal ladder. We also have black in the sconces, and the sconces themselves are actually a mixed metal with the introduction of brass. And brass for us is such a huge element in a space. We love to put it in our fixtures and our decor elements. So we had that selected for the knobs because they were sort of a subtle detail with the vanity. We didn't want them to be a high contrast there. And then we went into selecting them also for the fixtures throughout the space.
Yeah, we absolutely love how brass feels, and it just brings a warmth to many designs, especially when you're contrasting it with tile and stuff like that. And I think it's maybe of a bit more unique look for shower heads. So we picked some beautiful fixtures from Jack Lowe, and we're just absolutely thrilled how they look. They do patina a little bit over time, but we're starting to think that that's part of the look. It gives it some real lived-in warmth that we absolutely love.
Yeah. When we were selecting the fixtures too, I think we had gone through a few different iterations of that as well. We wanted them to feel modern but kind of classic at the same time. So I'm really happy that we went with the three hole for the sinks. It has this, you know, nice kind of rounded edge detail. And then for the shower fixtures, we actually started with, I think, one shower head and then two, and then we ended up with three separate ones, each with their own functionality.
Yeah, we added the rain shower later on. I think we weren't planning to do it. Yeah. So let's just do it. And then we'll absolutely love it. I always shower both of them on. And you kind of like,
I know, you like
swag in between.
Dance in there.
You keep your hair dry, but you get your body on both sides. It's great. I love it.
My favorite element of the ensuite definitely has to be everything.
It's hard to choose. Yeah.
It is hard to choose. I would say the vanity, just because I just love having that kind of workspace to get ready in the morning.
I'll have to go with the shower because I absolutely love the shower.
Fair enough.
Okay, so that concludes our tour of our ensuite renovation. Again, this is something that we've been planning for so long, and we're just so thrilled that it's finally done and we can share it with you. We hope you enjoyed, and we have so many more spaces in our fully renovated house to show and share with you and give you all the details. So stay tuned, we've got a lot more coming. Hit that subscribe button and we'll see you in the next video.
We're Melissa and Sasha.
Okay.
Wait, what's our name again? This has been our ensuite. It's gonna be awesome.
That's the one.